Hi folks, Artist Mac here, back with another exciting episode of What the Clutch. Alright, here is the new slave cylinder from Rodney Dickman. It comes in two parts, the slave cylinder and the rod. The only thing you have to do to install the rod is put a little grease on the end that goes in the cylinder. And can you see what I'm doing right there? No, you can't because my arm is in the way. There we go. Alright. Up and in. Up and in, up and in. I hope everything on this job is going to be that easy. So it's a lot easier to show you how to get the old clutch cylinder off using the new one out of the car. And this is about the angle that you would see it when you're looking down at it with the hood open and that left cover off. Be in about this angle. First thing you have to do is loosen the clutch line, and the clutch line is under here, and it takes well, if you have a stock car, it takes a 14 millimeter crescent wrench, and then you want to get the bolts off that are holding it to the bracket that holds it in place. And these are going to be 13 millimeter. Now there is a bolt on, two bolts on this side, and then there are nuts on the other side that are holding the bolts in. And this whole assembly, when it's all together, it pushes on the clutch arm and releases and engages your clutch. So, let's see. Oh, and this is your bleed screw. Okay, now on the 84 Iron Duke, this is what the slave cylinder setup looks like. There's the bleed screw. The bolts are underneath this coolant tube. And I'm not even going to bother taking it off because you can get to them fairly easily from under there. And then right there where my flashlight is, that's the clutch arm where the rod goes in. So I'm going to go on ahead and get this off. Now, the clutch fluid line is under here, so you've got to get under there with a 13 millimeter, and it's not going to show up because I've got it on the highest light setting so you all can see it. But anyway, this is a 13 millimeter crescent, and you just get under there and lefty-loosey. As you're loosening that clutch fluid line, good idea to have something under there to catch the fluid as it starts streaming out. Even if you've, you know, emptied the system, there's still going to be stuff up in there, so good thing to do. Get to it. Yeah. There is the removed clutch line, and not too much fluid dripped out, so that was good. So, on to those attachment bolts. And right down here is the 14 millimeter connection that you're gonna have to get off. And it's just turn, and finally it comes off. All right, moving on. Here's one of the bolts They both come off the same way. What you're gonna have to do is get your 13 millimeter socket on there, and then you can't see it, but underneath here there is a nut, again 13 millimeter, holding this bolt on. You're gonna have to get your crescent wrench on there and hold it in place while you turn the nut up top. And I'm gonna have to get this camera out of here because I don't have any space for leverage. But anyway, just turn it and it should come off. Got one of those bolts out. Now, gotta get back in here. Again, I gotta take the camera away and get out the other one, because it's tight up in there and it's fiddly, and I don't want to accidentally drop the nut that holds this bolt in there. And boy, were they dirty. Well, I had to put some PB Blaster on them to get them out, but I'm gonna use some carb cleaner on them, on both bolts and both nuts, and clean them up. Okay, once you get those two bolts and nuts out, on the last bolt, you may have to push it in a little bit to get that last bolt out, but once you do, slave cylinder just comes back out. If you wonder what this thing is, this is from a long ago Chapman lock, and when you press it from inside, it hasn't worked in a good 10 years. But once you press in the lock on the inside, it still does lock the hood, so no one should be able to take the battery, and no one has in 34 years. But anyway, here's the old slave. Old slave cylinder, new, from Rodney Dickman. Now, I want to show you what's happening with the old one. Okay, you press it in. Oh, I don't think it's supposed to do that. Okay, now the new one. Presses in very gradually. And it comes out very gradually. So, old, new. So I take it that the new one is operating like it should, and the old one is kind of got a little sclerosis there. Write me in the comments section. Let me know. So now we're going to let the bolt soak in some carb cleaner. Get all that gunk off. While I go and buy another can of this. No more. Alright. See you in a bit. What did the Martians say on those old Bugs Bunny Warner Brothers cartoons? Delays! Delays! This particular delay, okay, on the old slave cylinder, the tubing that I bought goes over the bleed screw just fine. It's just slightly too big to fit on the bleed screw on the new slave cylinder that I bought from Rodney Dickman. So I have two choices. I can either go out for just this job for the bleed and buy a smaller diameter tubing, which is going to take more time out of the day, or I can take the lazy man's way out. I can just take this bleed screw off the old slave cylinder and put it on the new slave cylinder, which I plan to do. Problem solved. Oh, almost forgot. For the bleed screw, 10 millimeter wrench. I wasn't planning to show you this, but old bleed screw in front, new bleed screw in back. Notice how much longer the bleed screw on the Rodney Dickman slave cylinder is than the old bleed screw on the slave cylinder that came with the car. So if you see that, that's how it is. It shouldn't affect the installation of your old bleed screw on your new slave cylinder. One will just be sticking out more than the other. They have the same, where is it? Yeah, they both have the same little holes where the fluid goes out when you loosen the bleed screw. All right, just wanted to show you that. Okay, here's where we are. This is the bleed screw from the new slave cylinder on the old slave cylinder. I just put it there because it's a convenient place to put it. The old one isn't hooked up to anything. I just have it propped up here to show you. Now let's move to the new slave cylinder, which I have put the old bleed screw on. The old and the new will fit in the same hole. Now, here's what was happening. Where is it? With the new bleed screw, this thing barely fits. But it does fit properly. You know, it's very tight on the old one. And kerplop. So now I can get going with the bleed. I tell you, folks, you gotta be flexible in this life. And I don't just mean doing the belly dance and wiggling your way under Fiero dashboards. If A doesn't work, try B. And if that doesn't work, try C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, M, L, O, N, O, P, Q, R, X, 2, V, W, X, Y, Z, and then move on to the double letters and the numbers. If you don't have a helper for this, you can use a long broom handle so you can pump the clutch and pump the clutch and press it down. As well as turn the bleed screw and open it up. So that's what I'm going to do now. And keep checking the master cylinder up front. And if you have to, top it off. Because as you're doing this process, as the fluid is coming out here, the fluid level in the master cylinder is going to be coming down. So press the clutch pedal in and hold it, either with your foot, or, well, the foot of your helper, or with that broom handle. And then open up the bleed screw and let the fluid come out. And I think you can see it coming out. It's the yellow. And press clutch pedal in. Open bleed. There's some bubbles. Close bleed. Squash. And you have to keep looking back here to make sure that the level of your clutch fluid doesn't get down to that silver thing, or it's gonna draw in air and you're gonna have to start all over again. I don't seem to be getting any air out here. I'm still getting a lot of air bubbles out of this system. So what I'm gonna try is what people have been recommending. So Archie is saying remove the bleed screw. I don't think I'm gonna do that. I'm just gonna keep the bleeder on there. But what I'm gonna do, what I'm gonna do is grab the rod push it in as far as it'll go. Ugh. And I don't know if you could see that, but it looked like it got some air out of there. So, alright, let me go try and go back. Oh, when you put this rod in here, of course, you have to get it back into the hole that it came out of. You have to guide it in there. Alright. Gonna give the rod pull one more try. Pull it back and yep. I think we're good. I hope we're good. Does this car stop working in the middle? Not the middle, the end of February. And you know my trials and tribulations trying to get it going ever since. I'm gonna lower it down, start it, put it in gear, and see what happens. I hope I'm as successful as I was with the lawnmower. Okay, let's see what happens. Yep, there we go. Get out of gear. Okay, press the clutch, turn the car on. Nothing. Not a thing. At least I can get it into. No? Let's see. Yeah. I can get it into the gears. Well, the car is off. But I did let the battery go down because I had the door open. I was working and left it open, but it shouldn't be doing this. Well, it was doing this before. Now it's not even moving as far as it was. Folks, I am fresh out of ideas. Do I need a new clutch lever? Is that the problem? If there's any of you who have been through this before, please write me in the comments section.